What did on the long gray old drive time? And much as man is around. In the morning, 8:37 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, episode 99. How's everyone doing today? My name is Vernon. And you are indeed listening to Drive Time, or you're watching Drive Time. You're watching the bright, beautiful blue skies of central New Jersey pass overhead. Well, who's passing who? Am I passing the sky, or is the sky passing me? It's being captured with the camcorder function, the lens, the computer that is an iPhone 4S. Make some noise for the iPhone 4S's of the world. We don't need no 5s. There's a tour bus on my right. You can't see it because you're looking at the sky, but there's a beautiful Alpine Coach, was the brand name. It's a beautiful brand name. Alpine Coach. There's a guy wearing spandex jogging. Okay. It's commitment right there. I think I look like a fool sometimes wearing my getup, but you know, I shouldn't think that. There's brothers out there with the spandex on. The girly spandex. I would actually probably enjoy wearing that. I think I have urges to wear, like, you know, I was in a play in high school, Brigadoon, so I think I wore tights and a kilt. And I acted like I hated it, but I think I liked it. I like becoming something that you're not. So that guy momentarily, he's spandex, man. He's running for his life. It's good to run for your life. If you can't live like you're running for your life, what's the point? Because really, we all are running for our lives. We're chasing the inevitable demise. We're doing it with bananas. We're doing it with H2O. We're doing a little love and tenderness, cement, twigs. I'm feeling okay today. The weather, man. Fucking weather. You get out there and it just feels good sometimes to have some sun and some warmth hitting your skin when you leave your house. Not spend too much of the day on the computer, or, you know, the computer's fine. I'm not saying you shouldn't spend. I could spend all day on my computer and feel fine, okay, but that. That's not true. I could spend 90% of my day. You need to get out. And on a nice day, it affords you the opportunity to get out and live life a little bit. I've been listening to a lot of motivational type stuff. Not cheesy motivational stuff, but, you know, cheesy. But, also pretty good, you know. I don't know. It's bogus in a lot of ways. But there is something to that. To just, you know, letting go of the self. Not having, defeating your fears, really. Defeating your fears will open it up so you can then work on defeating the anger and depression that you feel. Like, I don't know, is there humans out there who don't feel anger and depression? Like, are there people who are just like, wake up every day and they're just like, content? Like, those people are lying, right? They've perfected the art of lying to the point of, like, where, like, they can lie to themselves so much that it becomes almost the truth. But, or is it a truth? Is it possible? It feels like it's not possible. That's the quest, in my opinion. IMO. IMHO. My hand smells like onions. I don't know why. Eat onions. Forgot. I think I was cutting. I don't think I've touched an onion in at at least 2 days. Very weird. Mysteries. Oh, frickin'. There's a dog shelter I pass every day on my way to work, and it's a no-kill shelter. So I like to give like a mental shout out to the people there. I once, when I was lost in life, which I'm telling you, I'm like more lost than I normally am, and I was jobless, I went to I did an interview at a animal shelter up in northern. Way north of this part of New Jersey. And I, you know, it was like a kind of a rural, I mean, I don't want to say it wasn't rural, it was probably like, you know, it was in the middle of nowhere, and it was kind of like on like a beautiful property, many acres, but it was a kill shelter. And, you know, the lady who interviewed me was just very cold, and she's like, you're going to have to kill animals if you get this job, you know, if you want to work here. And, you know, in my head I was thinking like, okay, well, this is the duty that these people have to do. They're ultimately trying to do something good, I think, right? This happens. You know, but I don't know if I could ever killed like a feral cat. And I left it up to like, okay, all right, you know, I didn't walk out of there, but I didn't say, you know, yes or no. I was like, okay, well, let me know. And so she's like, yeah, we'll call you. She never called me. She must have seen something in my face, because I don't think I could ever really, when it came down to it, I don't think I could end a life in my hands.